show, and he told me that he and his family also had had many bizarre, unexplainable experiences in the house. Now, he stated that they were not physically attacked like my family and I were, but they did have many, many bizarre experiences, and he did go on the record, and he will be in the next book.
My goodness.
So, you know, again, I'm saying that it started in 70, and we moved into this three-bedroom ranch-style home located in Glen Burnie, Maryland, and the neighborhood was called Herondale. And I just knew from the start that something, I was 4 years old when we moved in there, and I just knew at my first glance, I just knew something was wrong. I was frightened, and I shouldn't have been frightened at the age of four. I should not have certainly had a reaction like that just by going to a house or looking at a house. And it wasn't long after. I mean, it's probably 2 days after we had moved in, and my mother was the first to have an experience in the house, and it occurred while she was unpacking boxes in the living room. My father, now they were married in 56, so they had been married for quite a while before moving into this house, and by all accounts were very happy. My father was a very hardworking family man, and my sister was born in 57, so she was 13 when we moved to the house. I was four, my brother was one. And, again, by all accounts, they were very happy and things were going well in their lives until moving to this house. And on this day in particular, we had been there a couple days. My mother was in the living room unpacking boxes. My father had taken us to his parents' house for the day to leave my mother alone and let her unpack and organize. And it was while she was doing this that she felt a presence, and she felt a presence come behind her. And in her mind, she truly thought that it was my father sneaking back in to play a joke, because he did have that type of sense of humor. And so she spun around fully anticipating to see him and really hoping to startle him. And as she did that, nothing or no one was there.
So it seems, I remember the last time you and I talked, Bill, and I asked you if anyone else previous in your family had had any experiences, and you said no. And to find out that your mother and your uncle.
Isn't that amazing?
It is. Now, my question to you, Bill, is it possible that this connection with these entities goes back further?
Yeah, much, much further. Yeah, there's no question about it, because, again, my sister had given me some old family photographs that belonged to my mother. And when my mother passed, which we'll get into that a little later, When she passed, my sister got those photographs, and just lots and lots of old photos. And my sister, a couple Christmases ago, said, "Here, have some of these, have some of Mom's photos." And I took them. Mm-hmm. And as you know, and we can go into this a little later as well, I've had many, many experiences in my life dealing with many different types of phenomena. And so when I'm looking at photographs, I am looking at the photo, but I'm also studying the photo for anomalies in the photograph. And I found quite a few in some of the old family photos, and two in particular, really, three actually, really stood out to me. And I'll have to send you these photographs.
I'd love to see them.
Feel free to post them if you like.
Oh, you know I will.
One was taken in 1968. I was 2 years old, and I'm seated, it looked like it was Christmas time. I'm seated behind this piano, toy piano. My sister's to my left, and to her left, very far in the picture, it's like to the edge of the picture, but it's unmistakable. It appears to be this very tall, looks like 7 feet tall, cloaked figure. It's a black hooded cloak, and you see this gigantic hand coming out from under the one of the arms of the cloak. Rob, it's unmistakable. I'll have to send it to you. And that's when I saw that, boy, that just, that definitely gave me chills. And that was in 68. And then another photograph was taken in 69 of me at the age of three. And it's just supposed to be a photograph of me. And you see in the photograph many others, types of beings. There are three behind me in single file that are different heights. Some have a clenched fist, some have an open hand, and they appear to be humanoid, but But then when you look further in the photograph, if you look to my left, you'll see two things that really stand out. One, and I was standing in front of brush, in front of, not shrubbery, but it looked like in front of like bushes or brush. And if you look to my left, you will see what appears to be some sort of gigantic face. And it almost looks like, I guess the best way to describe it to you would be sort of like an Indian type of face or a mask. I mean, just very, very large facial features. The face was more brownish red and just very, very bizarre. And then in front of that, which would have been to my left, appears to be an alien-looking being. It's 3 feet tall. It appears, you see the big black eye, and it looks like one of those little gray alien things that they talk about. And just absolutely bizarre.
Unreal, Bill. Unreal.
And then the third photo was taken in 1975 in that house, and it's a photograph of my mother, and she's on the telephone, and I assume that my father took this before he left us. He did leave us in 1975. I'm assuming it was my father that took the photo. And it shows her on the telephone. Now, behind her, it was a closet that my father had taken out of there. And he opened it up, and he made a bar and put mirrors behind it. And also, you see this very long and large rectangular mirror behind her. And then to her left is an oval-shaped mirror. Well, in the oval-shaped mirror beside her, and again, this is unmistakable, I will send you this photograph, appears to be this very large alien-looking face. And I mean, it's unmistakable. And there it is, you know, just like you would be looking at a person in the photograph. And then to her right appears to be, again, one of these little guys that looks like about 3 feet tall, and you can see the flash of the camera coming off of its gray head.
Bill, stand by, buddy. You and I have to take a commercial break. This is just amazing because, like I said, the last time you and I were on together, I had asked you if anyone else in your family, and at that time you said no, to find out that your mother and your uncle both have had experiences. You're right. This is definitely an entity or a group of entities who have attached themselves to your family.
Yeah.
And it's going to be quite a mystery to find out why. Stand by, Bill. You and I will return on the other side of this commercial break with the news. Bill Bean's my very special guest, good friend to the X-Zone Nation. Bill's got a new show that's starting this coming Sunday. We're going to tell you how you can listen to it. And his website, www.billbean.net. That's www.billbean.net. He's the author of Dark Force, and Bill and I will be back on the other side of this commercial break as we continue live and around the world from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, on Talkstar.
It'd be a perfect white Christmas.
Are you considering calling a psychic to read your situation? Then consider David Champion, a psychic medium for more than 20 years with thousands of readings under his belt. David Champion will make you feel comfortable. He has proven to be honest and accurate. He's a straight shooter. There's no guesswork. What he sees is what you get. While he is a medium, most of the calls focus on relationships. Not only love, but work, school, neighbors, and more. Need help with finding a job and preparing for the interview? Are you dealing with people who are obstacles in your path? For more information, go to davidchampion.com, $1.50 per minute, paid by credit card, with a minimum of 30 minutes. For your reading with David Champion, call 1-877-702-8598. That's 1-877-702-8598. Now you can dial in to listen to the X Zone Radio Show from anywhere in the world with Rob McConnell 24/7, 365 by dialing 213-401-0080. That's 213-401-0080. If you have a mobile phone or landline, the X Zone Radio Show with Rob McConnell is now at your beck and call at 213-401-0080. That's 213-401-0080, 24/7, 365.
Hi, this is Ed Shiflett, COO of White Springs Media, wishing all the X-Zone Nation, Rob and Laura, and everybody else a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Of a white Christmas.
All through the year we've waited through spring and fall, to hear silver bells ringing, see winter time bringing the happiest season of all. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe will help.
Bill Bean is my special guest, Exonation. He is the author of Dark Force. His website is www.billbean.net. That's www.billbean.net. And Bill has a radio show starting this Sunday. Bill, tell us all about your show. I'm so happy for you.
Oh, thank you, brother. Yeah, it's a real blessing, and it's something that I never thought that I would be doing in a million years. Honestly, I never envisioned this, and I'd had a couple offers to do this, and I felt I always ask God about everything, and he give me signs if it's the right thing to do, and I believe he did give me a sign telling me it was the right thing to do. So the show is called Keeping the Faith with Bill Bean, and it airs every Sunday evening at 9 p.m. Eastern, and you can visit www.wfixfm.com, and that's where the show is podcast, and again, it's a blessing. And what I've done, the first couple weeks is just sort of like a commentary to let people know who I am, where I have been, and where I am going, where God is leading me.
Right.
And I'm just quoting from the Holy Bible and filling people up with the Holy Scriptures and with God's Word and the Word of Jesus Christ. And that's really my mission, Rob, is just to help people make their covenant with Jesus Christ, who is the one and only Savior. And I just feel it's so important, because I just have this, and this would be a whole other show, and I don't want to get on it too long, but I truly believe we're in the last days before the return of Jesus Christ, and I feel that it is so important for people to make their covenant with Christ before all this comes down.
All right, Bill, since you opened the door to the last days,
yeah,
what's your opinion of 2012? Is it doom and gloom, or is it the beginning of a new spiritual revolution?
Well, now, God has not told me anything, so I go by what I feel, and again, I could be wrong, because I'm a man, and as we know, we are corrupt. We have to rely on God, but based on what I feel, I truly feel that it could be a cataclysm that comes, and I hope not. I'm not bringing this on or wishing it, but I have a feeling that it could be a cataclysmic event that precedes the return of Jesus Christ, and because scriptures do tell us that a star by the name of Wormwood would come and fall into the waters and would kill a third of the people on the earth and would poison the waters. And again, not trying to scare anybody, you know, I'm certainly not wishing that this will happen and wishing that that would come. However, I truly feel that way, And in feeling that way, I feel that it is so urgent for people to make their covenant with Christ, because I don't want to see anyone left behind. If something like this were to happen and sweep us away in the blink of an eye, the comfort in that would be knowing that you've made your covenant with the one and only Savior, Jesus Christ. Then you don't have to worry. You know where you're going.
Bill, if you would not have had the experience and the experiences as you describe in your book,